This video is provided as supplementary material for courses taught at Howard Community College. And in this video, I'm going to show how to do a transformation of a logarithmic function. So the basic function I'm going to work with is y equals the log base 2 of x. I've drawn a graph of that basic function. It's an increasing function. We can tell that from the logarithm itself. Whenever the base is greater than 1, you can have an increasing function. Like all basic logarithmic functions, it has a vertical asymptote along the y-axis, and it has an x-intercept at 1, 0. Okay, so let's look at some transformations of this. As with other functions you've seen, if I take the basic function and add a constant to it, like a positive 3, what that's going to do is raise or lower the entire graph by that many units. A positive constant will raise the graph, a negative constant would lower the graph. So in this case, I'm going to raise the graph up by 3 units. The vertical asymptote will remain the same. I'm just going to add 3 to each of the y coordinates for any points that I have. So I could take the point 1, 0, make that 1, 3. Take the point 2, 1, and make that 2, 4. And 4, 2 would be 4, 3. And then I could draw a rough curve in to sketch what that's going to look like. Okay? Besides shifting the graph vertically, I can stretch it vertically. If I put a coefficient, like a 2, in front of the logarithm, then what that's going to do, as with other functions you've seen, is stretch the graph vertically. It's going to take all of the y coordinates and multiply them by 2. So this point that I have here at 2, 1 would become 2, 2. The point at 4, 2 would be 4, 4. The x-intercept is going to stay the same since the y-coordinate there is 0, and 2 times 0 is still 0. I could take the negative coordinates that I have. I have a coordinate at 1 half, negative 1. That's going to go down to 1 half, negative 2. The vertical asymptote stays the same, and if I sketch the graph in, we can see that it's stretched out vertically by a factor of 2. If I put a negative sign in front of the coefficient, what that would do would be stretch the graph by that factor. If I have a negative 2 times log base 2 of x, it would stretch the graph by a factor of 2 and also flip it, reflect it across the x-axis. So I would have a graph that looks something like this. Stretched and reflected. Okay? Now, besides transforming the graph vertically with reflections and shifts and stretches, we can also move the graph horizontally. So if we have the log base 2 of, let's say, x plus 3, with that entire x plus 3 in parentheses, as you've seen with other transformations, when we add a constant to the x value, if that constant is positive, it shifts the graph over to the left that many units. So this x plus 3 is going to shift everything over to the left 3 units. I'll have a new vertical asymptote. That's going to be at x equals negative 3. The x-intercept, which was at 1, 0, would be at negative 2, 0. The point that was at 2, 1 would be at negative 1, 1. And this point at 4, 2 would be at 1, 2. And then I can sketch that in also. Okay, so that's just shifted 3 units over to the left. If I wanted to reflect the graph across the y-axis, all I would have to do is take the x and put a negative sign in front of it. the vertical axis would be the same, the vertical asymptote would be the same, but the graph would then be reflected across that vertical, across that y-axis. Okay? Now, let's see what we can do by combining some of these different transformations into one function. So let's try y equals 3 times the log base 2 of x plus 3 minus 4. Let's get an idea of what that's going to do. This x plus 3 is going to shift the graph over 3 units to the left. That's what we just saw, in fact. So I can draw that vertical asymptote in now. That's going to be at x equals negative 3. The 3 in front of the logarithm is going to stretch everything out by a factor of 3. And the negative 4 after the logarithm is going to drop everything down by 4 units. Okay, so let's make a table of values and find some points on this graph. I'm going to use x equals negative 2 to look for a point. The reason I'm doing that is when x is negative 2, then x plus 3 is 1, and the log of 1, no matter what the base is always going to be 0. So this will be an easy one to find. So I'm going to have the log base 2 of 1, which is 0. I'll multiply the 0 times 3, which is still 0. And then I'll subtract 4, so that's going to be negative 4. So I'm going to have a point at negative 2, comma, negative 4. I'm going to use negative 1 for an x value, because that'll take this x plus 3 and turn it into negative 1 plus 3, which is 2. And whenever the base and the number you're taking the logarithm of are the same, then the whole logarithm equals 1. So I'm going to have the log base 2 of 2, which equals 1, multiply that by 3, that's a 3, subtract 4, and I'll get a negative 1, which means I have a point at negative 1, comma negative 1. And the last point I want to use is 1. That's going to mean this x plus 3, or the last x value I want to use is 1. That means this x plus 3 is going to equal 4, and it's always nice when the number you're taking a logarithm of is a power of the base. So I'm going to have log base 2 of 4. Well, log base 2 of 4 is 2. So I've got this whole thing equaling 2. Multiply it by 3, that's going to be 6. And then subtract 4, and that's going to be 2. So the last point I'm going to plot is going to be at 1, comma 2. That will be up here. Given these three points and my vertical asymptote, I can sketch the curve in pretty easily. So it's going to go up like this. And this is basically the curve of the original graph shifted over 3 units to the left. That's what this x plus 3 does. And then stretched by a factor of 3. That's what the 3 coefficient does. And then dropped down 4 units. That's what the negative 4 at the end of the function does. Okay? So I hope that helped. Take care. I'll see you next time.